but I think it's the one that's probably the most rewarding.
When you walk down the street, they're like, ah, what's the first thing they say? Which is the first movie that comes out of someone's mouth?
It's one of the three. It's one, it's either Sixteen Candles.
You forgot my birthday.
Breakfast Club.
Where's your lunch?
You're wearing
it.
Do I ask somebody else?
Those three movies, yeah, I think Breakfast Club.
What is it about that film that captured you more than the other two?
I just think that it's a really interesting script, and the fact that it takes place all in one day, I think, keeps it from being super dated. I mean, I like all three of the movies, but that one I just think there's just something sort of perfect about it.
Don't mess with the bull, young man. You'll get the horn.
Everybody can link somebody in that cast of characters.
Yeah. I mean, there are archetypes, you know? I mean, I think if the film were done now, I think it would be expected to be a lot more racially diverse, because it is, I mean, if you think about it, it's a pretty white movie.
Did your mom marry Mr. Rogers? I promise, Johnson.
But on the other hand, so many different people, no matter what their race, no matter, you know, what their you know, gender preference relates to the movie, because it's just really about people that feel like outsiders.
What do you think about the overly self-conscious move to make every cast racially balanced? We're to have a story now, have somebody from each race and each sexual orientation and each socioeconomic group represented, as opposed to telling the story of a town where there's just lesbians.
I feel two ways about it. I feel like, yes, I can understand how that can seem precious and go a little bit far with political correctness, but by the same token, I think it's really important. You know, I think there are too many people who have not been represented, and I think the more that the less of an issue it seems. And also, we are becoming more racially diverse as a society, so it only makes sense that we're going to represent that in our art.
Do you feel like art has a responsibility to move society forward?
I think art is a reflection of society. I don't think we're responsible for teaching lessons, but we're responsible for having a conversation and having our art reflect what's going on in the world.
I heard you were covering one of the Breakfast Club songs on your latest record.
I do.
What a lovely homage.
When I was coming up with the song list for the album, John Hughes passed away, which was a big shock for me, and I think, are you thirsty? and I think for everyone, you know, it was, he died way too young. And so it really just came out of a rehearsal where it was on my mind a lot, and I always really liked the song. And so I just wanted to see if there was any way that we could turn it into a jazz song. And so my pianist started putting these really beautiful chords behind it. And I don't know, which is, I thought it was really nice. So we ended up putting on the album kind of as a tribute to John Hughes.
Why jazz?
I grew up with jazz. It's what I've done for longer than I've done anything else. My dad's a jazz musician, so I grew up singing with him. It's just like my musical version of comfort food. I just love it. Yeah, pretty much.
Molly Ringwald, you're into a million things. Top three projects right now.
Well, I think, of course, my album, which was just released by Concord, which is called The Stuff Sometimes. My book, What It Happens to You, which was published by HarperCollins. Oh, and I'm writing an advice column for The Guardian.
How fun is that?
Yeah, ask Molly.
All right, give me some advice on that.
What do you want? You have to tell me what
Okay, so